Tracking, alerting, protecting. This is WKYT News at 6.
Strong and severe thunderstorms rumbling across the Bluegrass State. I'm Chief Meteorologist Chris Bailey with a tour of live First Alert Defender straight ahead.
Fayette County school leaders say they're taking another look at tornado safety following the deadly tornado in Oklahoma.
A difficult day here in Powell County as a three-year-old is found unconscious in a pool. The update on his condition.
And a WKYT investigation 4 months in the making. Why are many recipients of government assistance withdrawing their money in the middle of the night? WKYT News at 6 starts now.
Good evening to you. Tonight we are tracking strong and severe thunderstorms moving across parts of the Bluegrass, and we have declared a first alert severe weather day to keep you informed.
The storms have caused some damage across parts of the Bluegrass. Let's run down what we know. This is a live picture from Pulaski County. High winds have caused part of a building there, as you can see, under construction to collapse. That building is along Highway 80, just west of Somerset. We've also received these eyewitness pictures of shingles damage and trees down at a home in Somerset. In Lexington, Kentucky Utilities, the latest on that situation, 7,000 customers without power right now in the Lexington area. Trees down along these areas, Spur Road, Clay's Mill Road, Paris Pike, Ironworks Pike, and DeLong Road. We begin tonight with our chief meteorologist, Chris Bailey. He is tracking what's happening right now on the First Alert Defender.
Guys, obviously, as we talked earlier, the calling card from these storms would be gusty winds. This is a gigantic wind machine now that is making its way east of Interstate 75. Where you see our radar, how things are kind of arcing here. You get that little bit of a bow shape and then individual bows within that line. That's where the winds are really gusting out ahead of this. Let's give you an update now on what's going on with the latest warnings here across parts of northeastern Kentucky. All the counties that are east now of Interstate 75 basically are under severe thunderstorm warnings. You see this warning that is out until 6:30. That's for Bath, Fleming, Menifee, Montgomery, Powell, and Rowan. That includes the city of Moorhead, impacting about 24,000 people within that particular warning. As we see that line continuing to work its way on off to the east, that will again impact the Moorhead area coming up very, very soon. Radar showing some gusty winds better than 60 and 65 miles per hour as that storm continues to slowly work its way off to the east at a very, very good clip. So it's right on top of Sharpsburg. It is right on top of the Bath County area. Let's zoom in on this particular part of the cell on top of Bath County, back into the Lexington Metro. Everything is beginning to clear out a little bit. Let's go a little farther to the east with our radar, and we will show you what is going on with that storm. And the particular storm that we're watching is going to roll its way eastward as we go into the next little bit. Let me step out of here and give radar. That's a live sky cam that we can see right now across the area. And what we are noticing with that particular band of showers and storms as it works its way off to the east, you see the individual bows within this particular thunderstorm complex. It's going to impact the Flemingsburg area, Owingsville, and Moorhead. That's the track that we were looking at, though. Looking at Defender right now, this stuff isn't as strong as what we were talking about a little bit ago. A little farther to the south, strongest potential storm is right on top of Stanton here into Powell County along the Mountain Parkway. That will impact Frenchburg and Menifee County, Hazel Green and Campton into Wolf County. Extending that view a little farther to the southeast into sections of Beattyville and Boonville and to Owsley County, and then right on into Bell County, Harlan, Hazard. This is on its way into your particular area. We can put a cone on this or a track on this for a squall line. Let us draw it all the way down and expand it to the northeast at around 35 miles an hour or so. And there you see some of the cities within the path of this line of damaging winds as it rolls to the east, eventually through the Flemingsburg area here very shortly, Jackson and Breathitt County. Moorhead at around 6:39 and over towards Salyersville a little after 7 o'clock this evening. The damage reports continue to trickle in across parts of central Kentucky, where Alex Hayes, our meteorologist, joins us now with an update on what all has been going on across the city of Lexington and the Lexington Metro, where a lot of trees are down, Alex.
That's right. We have reports of trees down across several busy roads. You heard Sam talk about that earlier. Clay's Mill and McCubbin Road, Ironworks Pike off Russell Cave, Paris Pike, Ironworks Park as well. Now, in Nicholas County, we do have a report of a 47-mile-per-hour wind gust. That's what's causing all of this these problems. You have a lot of rain that's moved through, that's helped moisten up the ground and loosen up those branches. That's why they're falling. Couple that with the strong wind gusts. We have, in addition to trees down in Lexington, we're also getting reports of trees down in Scott and Rockcastle counties as well. That's because of 40 to 50 mile per hour gusts there. Now, probably the most striking report that I've seen come through this National Weather Service chat is the report of a sign down on a truck. That's in Richmond, no doubt, because of the strong winds there. In Scott County, we also have thunderstorm wind damage. Again, just trees reported down. That's really the calling card, as you say, with these storms. And we're going to be seeing a lot more of that coming through. As Sam mentioned, that's causing a lot of power outages as well. We have over 7,000 people in Fayette County right now in the dark, a total of over 10,000 really in central Kentucky, and it's all because of these storms. And just to mention another damage report in northern Rockcastle County off I-75, that's about mile marker 73, a 51 mile per hour gust that's knocking trees down as well. So Chris, a lot of trees down, reports of power outages across the state. And that's really the big calling card, like you said, with these storms.
Yeah, that it is. Oftentimes, when you get these lines of thunderstorms to just race across the region, this is what you're going to be seeing. That line extends now from northern Kentucky through the southeastern corner of the state. And you can see those individual bows. That is a little bowing segment that is heading toward the city of Hazard, Jackson, Salyersville, West Liberty, on up toward the Moorhead areas. You're going to be under the gun here very shortly for winds that may gust around 60 miles an hour. That will be enough to knock down some trees, cause some additional power outages across eastern Kentucky. So what we're basically telling you is that if you're ahead of this line into eastern Kentucky, you're going to be placed under a severe thunderstorm warning very, very shortly. To the west of that, the back edge of the steadier rains are now located along I-75 from Lexington down to Richmond, so things are calming down. But as you were seeing on that Waze map, guys, you were seeing the speeds on some of the folks that were reporting in around 10, 15 miles an hour. That is obviously telling us that a lot of hazards are out there, so it is a slow go for that evening commute across the city of Lexington. And again, numerous trees down. We're going to keep an eye on this line as it works its way to the east, because the individual cells are going to cause some more serious problems across eastern Kentucky.
Chris and Alex, thank you. As we get more information, we'll pass it on. I haven't heard anything about it.